Hi out there in the YouTube and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to be talking to you about culture and how it is really important and necessary to love and integrate culture, whichever it may be, but at the same time, also know that it should hold very little importance to how you actually live your life. Now, you might be wondering, like, so what are you talking about there? I'm saying, like, you have to be, you know, like, respect Christian beliefs but not follow them? Yes, that's what I'm saying. And there's Hindu beliefs and lots of other people on the planet. They're all entitled to their opinions. And you are too. And it's your job through your own self-education to, you know, teach yourself of the world. And everyone's perspective when it comes to cultural teachings, whether it be tribal or, you know, more occultic or just occult, you know what I mean? Like any of that kind of stuff, any mental activity that you may have, if you feel like that in doing your activity, you are joining a group and you're conforming to some wavelength of thought, then that in itself is a conformity. And yeah, whoa. And you lose your individuality, because I want all people out there, Christian or Vedic, Hindu, all of the different ones, okay, like Protestant, Jewish, like what, Egyptian, like all of the different perceptions of the world. Are there entitlements, like a story? And I want you to really, like, the whole point of this video is to really take into mind the fact that any of the ancient seers, any of them, Ezekiel, like, you know, Ezekiel's wheel, like the eyes, and that follow you wherever you go, like, they're not talking about this crazy mystical wheel, like, it's your birth chart, and it is with you wherever you go. And it's different for everybody, kind of like their guardianship, or their gifts, or their curse, depending on how you would like to perceive it. And nobody wants, in this lifetime, to be alone. And I feel that a lot of people feel a separation from the Creator, because the Creator made everything. So if you're not in tune with the vibrations of nature, then you are out of, you would create like an interference pattern, because you are not in sync with nature. And it's important to be in sync with nature, because nature and your heart, as even Jesus is quoted as saying, that the kingdom of heaven lies in your heart. Well, that applies to all people. So ancient Vedic seers or Protestants or Christians, Catholic, like any of the religions out there. So as reference points to the expression of people's different way of naming, I'm going to say that, hey, this is a meter. I don't have a meter.
No, that's not a meter. That's 3.28 feet.
3.28 feet. I do declare no, that is not true. It's exactly 1 meter.
That is nothing like a meter. It's 3.28 feet. Measure it yourself.
Hmm. Now, do you think that those two individuals, if they never actually compared or were unified in giving the other person the opportunity to truly express themselves, that they would ever know if they were truly the same or not. That's why it's good to have the love and the appreciation for those other religions. That way you can actually look at it through a child's eyes with love and compassion and a curiosity for the world and wanting to have that understanding of where you truly live. They're seeking that divine inspiration, which was able to create the nakshatras, the Celtic zodiac, the Egyptian zodiac, how many are there? There's so many, and they're all accurate, is my point. None of them is the truth, yet all of them do contain it, because all of the people that brought that knowledge forward to us looked inside through meditation and deep contemplation of their world in their heart, and they received answers which they shared, which we can choose to ignore them and follow, because through kind of the sheep mentality, people want to be with whatever is popular or name brand. And I've never been for popularity or name brand. I've always just been my own brand and whatever that is, which is unique and complete only in me as my own perception. You don't have it. No one else in the world does. And I don't have your perception. And there's no way we can trade. There's no way through life experiences that either of us could be like the other. Hence, why it is important to have respect for the other. Because, you know, it's like you're my mirror staring back at me. And it's your reflection, the world. And if you would like to cast judgments on other people, you really only cast those judgments upon yourself, because we are all one, and yet we are all separate. But it is through the separation or the fall that we really learn. You know, you learn more through negative experiences than you do positive ones, because you are forced to change, and nobody likes to change. Everyone wants to remain the same. And it's very important to have respect for all of these different cultures, because if you actually don't argue about the names, but try to see the commonalities, there are so many. Like even in Astronomica, which is written like 2,000 years ago. Astronomica, that's a really cool book. I highly recommend reading it. As well as the Book of Soiga. There's Soiga, kind of like soya milk, kind of Soiga, the Book of Soiga, and that's this book. And the Voynich manuscript. As well as many others, clearly point to divinity that lies within ourselves. And it's very clear in this age of the Age of Kali, which is to be expected, that many people are in the shadow, because we are in the shadow time. But that does not mean that there is not light. And even in more of the golden ages, when there is pure light, it's not pure light, except for one moment, and one moment vice versa, for the wheel. It's time, and you cannot have a negative without having a positive. That's simply math, and it's very important to know the numbers and how that attributes to personality, and to therefore take a more detached approach at knowing everyone's components, and knowing not to take it so personally, because, you know, as within, so without, as above, so below. So if you paint everyone with the same brush, you do that. If you see everyone in negative because you've had negative experiences, you do that. Not the world. You paint it with your perception, your own mental cognition. You paint the world as you choose to. And you may feel like through this emotional battle that it's not in your control and that it's just the world. You need to let that go because it's very important to be all-encompassing. You know, like the key to heaven, in as Christians would say, is Jesus. Well, what does Jesus mean? Love. Your heart. Just means love. So it means like if someone has an opinion and it's different than yours, they can have it. You can think they're wrong. Like, but you shouldn't treat them or project negative energy on them. Because do you really think that that will help? Like if you had a child and they did something wrong and you just like smack them and you're like, oh my God, child abuse. Do you think that they learn more from your negativity? Whereas if you just let them learn from their mistakes. And there's many paths on the Kabbalah tree of life that lead to heaven. And everyone is on that path. And if people out there believe contrarily, you're entitled to that. But you shouldn't get mad at me. Because I've had all of my own life experiences and knowledge that I've accumulated, as do you. Which I can't fathom or understand, and likewise. But we can try to bridge that border or that gap by sharing of the tools that we acquired that information from in the first place. And not only that, but acknowledging that the most inner divine comes from within. So any of those prophets, any of the seers, they had to look inside. They weren't searching on YouTube for answers. They used their imagination. They went out in nature and they communed with God. And they were, or themselves, because kingdom of heaven is within. So, and they brought back hidden treasures from that. From that kingdom in your heart. And yeah, I hope that this has imparted some information or at least some food for thought. And you know, you all mean a lot to me. And it's really important to me that this message comes across because people who've been following me know that I'm very speak my mind. And as a Gemini moon, I can be all over the place. But I still have a fulcrum, a center, in which it revolves. And that is, I would say lately, for the past couple of years, it's been astrology. Because how can you deny that there is not the sacred element of every moment in our life when there can be such celestial influences? Like flying chunks of rock, burning things, giant balls of gas. You think that that's going to mold your character and your soul? Like, and you're entitled to think that. But at the same time, you're also entitled to learn more. And, you know, you're entitled to do so with love. So I hope y'all do, and give this video a thumbs up. And sorry for the, like, purple-y all the once in a while, but, yeah, give it a thumbs up, and, you know, subscribe if you're new, and, yeah, leave me your comments and all that, because I really do, it's all food for thought, and it's much appreciated, and, yeah, I look forward to seeing you in the future. Bye for now. Mwah.